Say welcome to Cloth Diapering 101 Lesson 5, Buying, Selling, Trading Your Cloth Diapers. Getting good diapers will equal a good cloth diapering experience. When you buy them, you can buy them new or used. If you buy them new, you can go to any store that sells cloth diapers or purchase them online.
Eddie says, be sure to ask questions.
Does this type of diaper go with this type of cover? How the heck do you fold one of these? What the heck is this? Asking questions will ensure that you get the type of diaper that you think will work best for you and your baby. Online stores are really convenient if you have an idea of what you want to try. Here are some that I like.
Eddie says, you don't have to be overwhelmed by diapers. Just pick one kind that you think might work for you and try a few.
If used diapers don't bother you, you can really save money by buying them that way. For example, you can get a Grovia all-in-one new for about $23.95. For used, you $18 or less. A Bum Genius 4.0? New, it's $17.95. Or used, you can get it for $14. Fuzzy Buns one-size diapers, $19.95. But get it used, you can get it for around $13 or $14.
And used diapers really can be quality. On the left here is a Grovia all-in-one that I bought new. And as you can see, it's clean. The elastic is very, very good and tight on the sides and in the back. And it's in overall very good condition. Obviously, it's new. On the right is a used diaper that I bought, a Grovia all-in-one, but you can see the elastic is just a little bit more worn. But other than that, it's pretty much the same. This one, $23.95. This one, I got it for $16.
If you want to buy used diapers, it's usually easiest, at least I've found, to do it online. There are sites such as DiaperSwappers.com or JillianDrawers.com. Or there are also groups such as Cloth Diaper Swap or Fluff Traders through Facebook.
Eddie says be sure the elastic still looks good and that your diaper doesn't have too much wear.
That could mean that your diaper won't last you very long or you'll have to do repairs on it. It may also help to check feedback on that seller if possible. A lot of times the seller will list where to find it. You will need a PayPal account.
Eddie says, it's a good idea to know your acronyms.
Most websites or groups will have an acronym document if you need to look up anything. So here are some examples. Alright, so let's talk about selling your diapers. If you want to get rid of any of your diapers, be sure to wash them a few times and clean them up as much as possible. Meaning, make sure that your Velcro isn't pilly and it's in the best condition that it can be in. Sun out any stains and make sure it's in presentable condition. Then, when your diapers are clean, take pictures of the outsides and the insides. Your next step is to price them. If they're in like new condition, you could probably sell them for about 25% off of retail.
Eddie says, check out what the diaper's selling for on other used sites. It might help you price it.
Then it's time to write your description. What kind of condition is it in? Are there any stains? Is there anything wrong with it at all? How much wear? How much are you asking? What size is the diaper? And what brand?
Eddie says, be sure your description is very thorough.
Your last step is to create your post. Here's an example. Another way to get or give diapers is through trading. In my experience, I found it best to cover my own butt by exchanging through PayPal. And the way we do this is we send each other money, so I might send them $5, they'll send me $5 back. And in the description, we say what we're trading for. And then there's a written record of the trade. So if you see a diaper that you like, but you can't afford to fork out the money for it, you can always ask if they'll trade for something that you're willing to give up that's about of equal value.
So there you have it. Buying, selling, and trading your diapers is as easy as that.